facilitation of reaching towards anterior direction. Okay. Now, you may use both hands or single hands. You stabilize your hands. Okay. And with the stabilized hand, you have to touch the targets. I'll keep some target here. You have to touch. So, can you go and touch? So, the most important thing is when you are moving the center of gravity, you have to maintain the extension in the spine. Okay, maintain the extension, reach. Yes. When you are going forward, look up. Okay? Yes. Reach. Why I said look up? When he looks down, see what happens to the spine. When he looks up, what happens to the spine, you see. Okay, now you look down, go forward. It happens to the flexion. Okay, now go forward, look up. Okay, it gets the extension in the spine. So, the minute movements which happens during the movement will change your whole posture. So that's why when you are trying to reach forward, you have to look up towards the task or towards the target. Next, same position. See, this is a good grip. So I don't hold completely, but I give the stability for the patients. Now, if I want to rotate, I go this side. If I want to rotate, I come this side.
With the hand and the neck.
Yes. Okay. So this is the stable position. We facilitate roll or rotations. Or in the stable position, we facilitate rotations. Now, if I feel some restriction, say at this particular position, I feel some restriction. So what we usually do is, we want to remove that restriction. So we keep our hands, lift your thigh little, put it on my leg, put it on my, okay. Now I keep his hands here, okay. So now I face restriction here. From this, I feel the rotation of the restriction. So now next position is, I want to move the spine because I am feeling the restriction is from here. So when I want to move the spine, I keep my fingers or hands, this is the trunk, the spinous process of the thoracic spine. I will keep on the same side of rotation, that means he's rotating towards right. I keep my thumb on the same side. Now I facilitate a push to move the spine towards the
rotation.
So many of the times you have to move your body. If I do rotation, then it comes rotation. Okay? If I am stable and try to move him, it is difficult. You have to move. When you move, it is easy to move the patients. Okay? So now I facilitate rotation. Now I see again, turn this side. Can you feel more easy?
Yes.
Rotation? Okay, similarly if it is opposite side, I do on the opposite side to facilitate the rotation.
Now, back up.
Now, if you have restriction in the thoracic spine or lumbar spine for getting extension, okay, there is a passive restriction of the thoracic spine or lumbar spine for the extension. Can you give me that bolster, please?
Bolster.
So, when you want to facilitate extension, hold again your hands. Okay? Now, I will make them sleep towards a extension of the spine. Okay, painful? Can you go more?
Yes.
You can keep the head down. Okay? I usually facilitate extensors or movement in the extension by keeping a bolster. Okay? So now, the range of motion should not be a problem, first. If the range of motion is not there, then you can facilitate the muscle activity in that range of motion. If you have restriction only in the range of motion, then you cannot facilitate the muscles. For example, I don't have range, can I facilitate muscles?
No.
No. So first you get the range of motion by doing a passive technique. Then you get a active. So now active, again, you have to move your center of gravity forwards and upwards. So this is a active control for the extensors. Up. 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 Excellent. Okay. So now we have seen extension facilitation. Mm-hmm. We have seen rotation facilitation. Okay. Now, if you want to gain more activities in rotation or weight bearing in the upper extremity, one side paralysis or one side more spasticity. So can you move little that side? Okay. I want to keep the affected upper extremity in external rotation. So this is internal rotation. Already hand is in this position. So I want to keep in external rotation of upper extremity. Okay. Keep it onto the weight bearing position. So now at this position, if the fingers are having problem, then I keep my thigh on the fingers. Mm-hmm. If the elbow is problem, for example, buckle, bend your elbow, bend. If the elbow is problem, then I keep my hand at the triceps to facilitate the activity of the triceps. If the pectorals is problem, then I keep my hand at the pectorals to facilitate the external rotation. So now, your hand should come and touch my shoulder. So what happened now? Automatically, okay, he gets weight bearing onto the affected hand. Okay, can you touch here? Okay, so automatically he gets a good amount of weight bearing on this side. Come, touch, hold. So if you want to prolong the weight bearing, you hold and you take up, take down, or turn this side, turn that side. So you will facilitate the weight bearing on upper extremity, which will be helpful for decreasing the tone and improving the activity in the upper extremity. Stop.